In this video, we're gonna look at how I took these photos with a Fujifilm macro rig. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. So I've been thinking lately, what if I would spend around $2,000 to buy a dedicated macro rig? What would it look like? I really do like my current full frame macro rig, but it has a couple of weaknesses. First of all, the viewfinder is very low resolution, only around 2 megapixels. I want more. And also, it could always be a bit lighter. So I landed in this setup. The Fujifilm X-T3, the wonderful Laowa 65mm 2x macro lens, and this little cute flash from Fujifilm. This flash has a manual wheel to set the strength, which really sold me. The Laowa 65mm lens is awesome and truly a reason to switch to APS-C for macro photography. And the X-T3 has manual wheels for ISO, shutter speed and so on. It really fits my style where I mostly use manual settings for macro photography. I made a diffuser out of a plastic can. And I chose to go with a diffuser that sits on the end of the lens, because that way it will not be in the way of the aperture wheel or the focusing wheel, which kind of happened a lot with my old diffuser. So this is how the whole setup looks, and today I went for a very short walk, 1 hour in the forest, to take some test photos and see what it could do. So finally, it is a bit warmer outside, and there were quite a few insects out today, actually. This little ant, for example. And the first thing I noticed when using this setup was actually how great it is with a higher resolution EVF. Most cameras on the market have around 2 megapixels, including the Sony a7 III that I was using earlier. But the Fujifilm X-T3 actually has 3.7 million pixels, and it really makes a difference, and especially in macro photography. Those extra pixels in the EVF makes it a lot easier to see if your subject is actually in focus or not. Pretty instantly, I really love the experience of using this setup. The menus on the Fujifilm camera are great, especially when coming from Sony. It's so easy to find settings and to set them. I really love that you can set the ISO and the shutter speed on wheels on the camera. That is so great and so user-friendly, if you ask me. And I love to be in manual mode all the time anyway, and it's nice with the Fujifilm cameras that they kind of are in manual mode by default. So it really matches my shooting style. The weakest part of this rig proved to be the flash. It delivered enough light in most situations, and the manual wheel for changing strength was so wonderful when you're used to having to go into some kind of menu to just change the strength, which is the most common thing you do with a speed light. But with two AAA batteries, the flash went out of power in just an hour, and I used very powerful professional grade batteries, so that was a disappointment. I will have to switch to a stronger flash, I think. And also the diffuser, it really didn't give me that soft light that I like. Look at the reflections on this ant, they are not diffused enough. So I will have to make a new diffuser and change to a stronger flash. But I think I'm really, really happy with the experience of shooting with the Laowa 65mm and the Fujifilm X-T3. It's such a great combo, it produces super sharp photos, and the dynamic range is great. It's hard to tell the difference from my Sony a7 III full frame camera when it comes to the dynamic range. So all in all, I am actually really happy with the camera and the lens. And one thing I found myself thinking on this short little test walk with this rig was that it's really easy for me to nail the focus and to do the composition, and I don't know why, but for some reason it's much easier to take photos with this rig. It could be that it is smaller, it could be that the EVF is high resolution, or it could be some other detail, but the whole package together, I found it really joyful to use, and I can't wait to use it with a better diffuser and flash. This video is sponsored by Squarespace. This is my portfolio website over at mwroll.com, and I built it using Squarespace in less than 30 minutes. It's so easy, just upload your photos and pick a beautiful template and you're ready to go. They have great analytics tools to check out any detail on how your visitors found you. You can even see what Google words they used to search for you. And they have many great tools to get the most out of your website. Even if the templates are really beautiful and professional looking, you can adjust any detail in them. Go to squarespace.com and sign up for free. And when you're ready to use it for real, use my code MICAELWIDELL for a 10% discount. Thank you, Squarespace. So, I think 2020 will be the year where I experiment more with smaller sensors. Next up, I think I will actually try the Panasonic G9, which I bought recently. That's the end of this video. Don't forget to sign up for my photography newsletter. It comes out once a month. It is packed with inspiration and tips and gear and great photographers. Sign up for free at mwroll.com.